There's Graham Eady sporting a very nice beard, which has come on a pace in the lovely cool English climate. And big things expected from him in this match. I've got to be realistic and say that I am great misgivings about this game from an Australian point of view. I believe that this England side are G'd up for a magnificent effort. And I like the amount of experience they've got in the team, with particular reference to George Nicholls and Steve Norton. Australia kick off, and Fairbairn's got possession. And in they go, and there's Fulton showing little trouble, and they drive him back 8 metres right to the quarter line. Well, Fulton certainly didn't tackle then like a man who's got stomach trouble. A strong, hard run there from George Nicholls from St Helens, who's not unknown to Australian players. The prematurely bald Thompson getting up, and we've got some kicking there as a penalty. Penalty, quite rightly, to Australia, and I agree totally with that. Jimmy Thompson lashing out with his feet in the tackle. That's for the referee to adjudicate on things like that. Not the players to resent being held in a tackle. And I hope the referee is consistent with that particular ruling throughout. The same should apply to Australians throughout the game too. First opportunity then for Mick Cronin to raise the flags for Australia. This is about 2 metres outside the 10-metre line. So it's about 35 metres out. And he's about 20 metres off centre. Quite a buzz going around the ground here, which crowd, as I mentioned and repeat, has built up dramatically in the last quarter of an hour. Now, for those that may be a little confused, the numbering of the forwards in international matches in England, the lock forwards are numbered 13, the second row is 11 and 12, the props 8 and 10, the hookers are number 9. Well, they're already giving an indication, this English crowd, of where their loyalties lie. Cronin. It's not there, it's too short. Fairbairn has it. In came Kerry Boosted very strongly. And he's stolen the ball from him. Australia on attack now. Olling, number 8, taking the ball up. A mighty solid defence here at Central Park. Krillich, Craig Young coming hard and on the burst. They're only about 10 metres away now. Jeff Gerrard going from dummy half. He's only about 5 metres away. Radonikis with a long pass out to Reddy, standing wide. Goes under a high tackle, loses the ball, kicks it backwards. Radonikis scoops it. It's been knocked back. The referee didn't give a clear signal to me that the tackle count resumed. There's Fulton with a bomb. The bomb's gone high. Fairbairn's flying for it, knocks it forward. It's a penalty to Australia. I think his signal indicated offside play. Yes, it does. Millwood was the man who in question who touched the ball in an offside position. Now, this would indicate that the referee is going to be... Well, he was very, very close to the action on that occasion. He was right beside the man Fairbairn, who stood under the bomb. And I've got to say, Barry, he didn't make a terrific fist of catching that one.
No, he flew very high, but he didn't get to the ball very clearly at all.
Well, he flew high, but his arms weren't up to receive the ball. I think it was a little bit of a negative jump, that one. He was a little bit concerned about his well-being, and who am I sitting in a safe commentary position to argue with that? He was under a certain amount of pressure. I think this is going to be a very close, tight, hard game, and I think this England side... they're going to take a power of beating. Cronin's kick is successful, so first blood. Australia lead 2-0. Off, Roger Millwood drives this one deep. Boosted takes it well behind him, and only a little fellow, and he brings the ball back well just outside the quarter. There's Olling, the willing workhorse from Parramatta, 10 metres outside his quarter. Krillich, Craig Young, Great tackling there by Thompson, right round the boot tops. Here comes one out to Reddy. Reddy goes straight and hard. Not making a lot of progress. This England defence is pretty tough stuff at the moment. His foot tactically kicking. That's a good one, but it's not found touch, and John Bevan has it. Brings it back to the halfway line. Stevie Nash right through the gap. Beautiful run by the little halfback. Fine tackle from Rodonigas with an assist from Ollie. And the ball's loose on the ground. Who's got it? It's six to go, says the referee, and Australia have it. Only about 8 metres short of the halfway line. That was Gerard that fell on it. Fulton serves it out to Cronin, cuts out a man, gives it away there to Edie, who's looking quite different with that beard. Now Anderson, oh, and he's wrapped up solidly. That was a great tackle by Paul Rose. Paul Rose, Barry Ross.
Yes, he played with Dapto down in the Wollongong competition.
Big strapping lad. Rodonigas making the half break, gets to the halfway line, almost in centre of the field. And we've got a player being called out. It's Len Casey from... he's been penalised, I think, for an attempted stiff arm in the tackle. Another penalty, and the penalty tally is...
3-0 to Australia at this stage.
Stevie Rogers coming up to take a kick for touch. That's just a bit too far away for anyone to kick a goal in this heavy atmosphere. Well, Rogers' kick is good enough to get touch and good enough to make about a 23-metre gain. Now Rodonigas, let's see if they've got a set-piece move on. They have. Fulton gives it away to Craig Young on the burst, gets it away to Price, who loses it forward, knock on. That did look dangerous momentarily. Solid tackle there. Stopped Craig Young, but he still managed to get the pass away just a fraction hard. Now the first scrum feed, and England have come up with it. Out there to Fairburn, the fullback, who's decked with a beautiful tackle there from Steve Rogers, right round the boots. On the blind side they go. There's Steve Norton, played with Manly Warringah. Got a pass away well to Millwood. Out to Nash, straightens and goes hard. Olling takes him high. Not a stiff arm tackle, took him round the shoulders. England moving the ball wide now. They've left it behind. It's a knock on though. Offside again. That's directly in front, and the referee is quite right. The England player dropped it forward. Another England player fell on the ball in an offside position. Well, no Australian fan can complain about the handling of the game to this point by the referee. Barry, he's 4-0 in the penalties, is that correct?
Yes, that's right. Very competent at this stage, isn't he?
Well, we could almost bottle him and take him back to Australia the way he's going. But the game's played over 80 minutes. From midfield. Mick Cronin successful with one from two. These sort of kicks... Cronin kicked by the bucketful last year or last season in Sydney. Directly in front. Strikes that hard and high. Another 2 points. Australia lead by 4 points to nil. Cronin puffing away there. From the kickoff, there's the ball taken by Boosted, and a little tiny knock-on seen by the referee there, and I think that's a good decision. It's a minute fumble. Here's the replay of this, and look at that stiff arm that missed there by Paul Rose. Anyway, this scrum going down, and there's a penalty. It's an incorrect feed by Rodonigas. And this will give England the opportunity from just on the quarter line. It'll be Fairburn. George Fairburn, who plays for Wigan, is the one of the idols of this local crowd here. What a good crowd built up. I'd put it somewhere in the area of 17 to 18,000. He's a metre outside the quarter. He's about 13 metres in from the side. There's virtually no wind at all here. It's a windless, slightly misty day. Great day for football. I might add at this point that the England coach, Peter Fox, was asked before the game whether we could go into his dressing rooms, and he declined, which, in my view, is a great pity. Bevan. And successful. So the score then remains Australia 4, Great Britain 0. Kickoff. Fairbairn's going to take that well. Likely fire. Ran into some solid defence there too in midfield. Just his own side of halfway from Fulton, who's showing absolutely no signs at all of stomach trouble or a stomach muscle tear. I get the impression that may have been a gigantic con job. Failing to get away from the tackle player. George Nichols, and another opportunity. Fairbairn around the corner type of kicker like John Gray. Goes back three long paces and a pace to the left. Comes in and hits it with the instep with the right boot. And that one's got height, got distance. Got everything. That's two magnificent points to Fairbairn. And Millwood gives him a touch of the hand as well he deserves. It was a great goal. 4-2. The kickoff driven hard and deep. Norton does the soccer act with it. Just gets outside the quarter. Had a great time with the Manly club in Sydney when he came there. Played very good football. Thompson on the blind side. Just trying desperately to get the play away from their quarter. Here's Nichols, one of the clever ball distributors in this England team. Now they come along the line to Norton. Stood up on the tackle, can't get a pass away. They swarm in on him. And that's the tackle. 6. 4-2. Australia lead. Steve Nash to feed. Well, Ward has definitely got a loose arm in that scrum, but he's got the scrum won. Nash, out to Millwood. Nice pass to Fairbairn. Fairbairn's got himself into the clear up midfield. Edie comes at him and takes him with a good side-on tackle. He should never have got to Edie. That was bad defence by Australia. Nichols unloading nicely out there to Casey. Casey tackled and put down, but not stopped. Gets up quickly to his feet. Norton's on the move. Throws the dummy. It's back inside. There's the ball gone loose. They're still with England. They're moving it wide across now. Back to Nichols. He's tackled well. With a good tackle from Ray Price. England well and truly on attack at the moment. Millwood. Nash, rather, with a long pass out there to Len Casey, standing wide on the open side. Here's the kick by Norton. It's a horror. I think he thinks he's playing rugby union. Trying to find a touch on the full. And Boosted. Has he come up with it? He has. And the referee's going to put down a scrum. Well, that was much too slewed off the side of the foot, that kick. But that was pressure from the England side. Shonky feed on that occasion, but the referees let it go. Little Boosted, the wing three quarter, coming in there from the blind side to do a halfback's job. Craig Young leaping through a tackle, gets outside the quarter. Thompson interfering with the dummy half there. Fulton serves it to Reddy on the blind side of the ruck. About 10 metres outside the quarter. Gerard. Ready again. Not ready. That's Edie. Fulton. Rogers. Quick hands. Cronin leaves it behind. The referee calls knock on. It was a bad pass. Went straight behind Cronin's head. He had all sorts of trouble to pull that one in. There's a Radonica speed that is allowed, and again, I say, it looked suspiciously like second row. Price on the blind side of that ruck. And a little tiny knock on. Fulton shows he's disgusted on that occasion. Not keeping the possession for lengthy periods, Australia. They're getting away with... there's a penalty. It's against a Radonica speed. I think that clearly indicates what the referee thought of that. Well, Australia have lost possession on the first and second tackle on the last two sequences, and that's not good enough in a test match. They've got to settle the play down. I think the fact that there are nine, am I right, Barry, players in this side playing against England for the first time?
Eight, Rex.
Eight. Well, is contributing probably to some of the nervousness we're seeing by some of these young men. George Fairbairn, who's already been successful with one from two, and the one that he kicked was a superb one. This is considerably shorter, a metre outside the quarter and a metre inside the 10 metre line from the sideline. Round the corner. Another great goal from the sideline to George Fairbairn, and the score then, after about 18 and a half minutes of play, Great Britain 4, Australia 4. 5 minutes to go. 4-4 the score. Neither side had a penalty against Radonikis, who, I must truthfully say, has looked as though he could have been penalised every time he's put the ball in a scrum today. Has finally penalised, and the statistics are Barry.
Scrums at this stage favour Great Britain 6-4, and the penalties are now 7-5 Australia's way.
Neither side looking as though they're going to assert any supremacy in this game. The handling from both sides has been very, very marginal, and that surprises me more with the Great Britain side than it does with the Australians, who are a young lot. This Great Britain side, a very experienced team. Plenty of years in there. One would have thought they could have kept the ball for lengthier periods. Fairbairn, 11 metres inside the Australian half, directly in the middle of the field. He gives the ball an almighty thump when he hits it. Kick, but it's worth 2 points. Didn't go end over end at all, but that's 2 points, and Great Britain hit the front for the first time, and they've got a lead now of 6-4. Fulton driving the ball deep again, trying to find an open space, which he has done. Well picked up on the run by Fairbairn, who doesn't go anywhere on that occasion. It's a Rogers tackle that stops his progress. Millwood. And Casey on the blind side of the ruck, towards the quarter line he comes. Ward, the hooker. Just over the quarter. Nash throwing the dummy. He's been dangerous on two notable occasions. Well, Nash came round, and there's a penalty, quite rightly. Nash wheeling around, no doubt we'll see that again. Craig Young got his leg caught in Nash's body on the tackle, and then Nash appeared to lash out and retaliate. Now there's Young, who's got his foot caught. It wasn't a kick attempt, but Nash's was. Derry Ross, an observation from you. Mick Cronin doesn't appear to be hitting the ball with his customary power.
No, he's not striking the ball like he did in Parramatta, with Parramatta, I should say. I noticed before the game, Frank Stanton told him to put the extra long sprigs on, and perhaps Rex, while this may enable him to hold his footing better, perhaps it's hindering his goal kicking.
Well, that's a possibility. It's also a possibility that he's slightly out of form, as he has not been kicking goals the last two matches. He got that one well and truly into the air. It's successful. So all our previous discussion was academic, but frequently when a player is not getting distance with his kicks, it's because he's trying to steer rather than strike the ball hard. And that's the scoreline, 6-6. Now we've only got about half a minute by our time, which is not official time, to go till that half-time break, which I'm sure both sides are going to be pretty happy about. Boosted. Diminutive wing three-quarter. Ray Price under a head high. Makes a good break. That's a typical Price bit of football. And that's the half-time break. At the half-time, it's 6-6. Millwood kicking off. Let's recollect the score is 3 penalty goals each. Boosted. Tiny little winger with a huge, huge heart. Krillich, over to Craig Young. And he makes a good bust. That's a good little run. And Australian forwards have got to back each other up in the second half here. Ready, turns it back inside to Olling. Olling gets towards the edge of the ruck. Norton and knees again from Nichols. This player's going to get himself a serve. Somebody's going to walk up and smack him right in the mouth before the end of this game, and I hope when they do, they make it a good one. Because the referee doesn't appear as though he's going to do anything in the world about the knees he uses from time to time. Edie to Price. Good defence. It's Thompson, the balding player in the England side. Radonigas half through the gap, and that's the six. He's so much like an Australian type of player, and he's a model tackler. In 90% of cases, he's right round the shins. Scrum fed, knocked on by Radonigas. Nash round like a flash. Thompson always gets up with an aggrieved look on his face as though has somebody done something terrible to him. There's a Fulton wrapped up hard. Little Nash round there. A great piece. Price through one. Over the top, looking for support. Nobody there again. Absolutely nobody there. He stood in the tackle for 3 seconds. Krillich, Radonigas, Fulton. Out there to Cronin, the dummy. Looks inside, gets it to Edie. Edie on the boil. Busted one, still going. He's about 10 metres now from the England quarter line. Norton was in late for that tackle. Radonigas, underneath the tackle, there goes, I think that's Gerard, fighting his way to his feet. Ready, Cronin. And great defence again by this Great Britain side. They're tackling just as well as the Australians. Fulton, up she goes. Fairburn under pressure, takes it well.
Nichols came through late after that kick by Fulton and pushed him in the face as he ran away. They had a bit of a disagreement.
That's the Great Britain side in possession, only about 15 metres from their line. Casey slowly to his feet. Ward at dummy half. Out there to quite a fleet-footed Paul Rose. He's a big fella too. Was facing anywhere but forward when he played that ball. Norton with a lovely bit of football. One-handed pass out there, but unfortunately for him, it was knocked on. And the referee has called knock-ons both ways. 10 metres, the scrum inside Great Britain's half. Oh, bless my soul. Yeah, Radonigas on that occasion. Norton on the blind side. And Casey. Crowd calling for the Australians to be put back on side. I must say, the referee has been a bit lenient with the 5 yards. Ward comes straight and hard. The score 6-6. Nichols. Nash, Millwood, little chip over the top. Boosted. Takes it beautifully. Well tackled too immediately by Bevan. Edie. The big Australian fullback makes a good diagonal burst to the quarter line and settles that play down again. Gerard. Looking for work near the ruck. Pilichard dummy half, about 8 metres outside their quarter. Olling bleeding heavily from the right eye. Just keep your eye on that eye of his, will you? It seems to be something quite a nasty nature. Fulton, Cronin, Rogers, comes inside. Magic footwork, but runs into solid defence there. Rodonicus, Fulton, to Reddy. Long, long pass out to Boosted. Goes back inside, gets to the halfway, loses the ball. It's Australia's ball still, and should be six to go if they can get to it. Well, that's a bit of slack play by Australia, but they have come up with it. Rogers, Young, Fulton, Cronin, out to Price. Price has got the half break on the outside, gets it back into Cronin, then to Fulton. Fulton for looking for support, gets it out to Anderson. Anderson wrapped up 8 metres the other side of halfway. By other side, I mean Great Britain's half. Krillich, Rodonicus, Olling wrapped up straight away. Didn't appear to be prepared to get that ball in. Krillich, ready, juggles it. Back inside to Fulton, look to touch forward. The referee says play on. Still six all. Cronin with a slack pass behind him, one-handed. Price fell on it, it's the last one. Here's Fulton, little chip through. He's been decked. The referee says play on. Millwood now, is it, to receive attention? Rodonicus standing there over him. The referee looking for... Now watch Fulton here. He's got the kick into the air and then he's really decked. And maybe Bobby's ability to take a dive has percolated through to England. Maybe we could look at that at a later date. Australia in possession from the ensuing scrum. It wasn't a penalty, it wasn't offside play, it was designated a forward pass as such a scrum. Fulton now to Olling. Olling still not getting on the ball away as much as he should. He should attempt to unload a little bit more than he does, Graham Olling. Gerard, who's found gaps, gets it away to Krillich. Even that sort of little bit of interchange of passing breaks the defence up. Craig Young, the Fulton, ready, the dummy, and a pretty good one too, it fooled me. Last tackle coming up with the lights on here at Central Park Wigan. Score 6-6, Fulton. Drops for goal. It's a goal. That's a point lead to Australia. They've got it 7-6, and that was a calculated bit of football by the Australian side. They worked very well to a plan to work play into the middle of the field there, and it paid off for them. No tries in this match. 7-6 the score. There's the Doug Walters stamp. A little bit out of season, but you know what they mean. Graham Eady, the bearded Graham Eady. Always hard to tackle. Cunningham and Ward the tacklers. Price, Australia, can they expand this lead? Fulton, two players, as you'll recollect, sent off in the, about the 10th minute, was it, of the second half? Yeah. Ash and Rodonicus. Gerard again splitting them up the middle from dummy half. Oh, and Krillich has lost it in the tackle as he fell for it. Bad bit of slack football there. At the halfway. Norton, who's been by far one of the most dangerous players. There's a touch, Jim. It'll be a penalty to the Great Britain side, one would think. And it will be against Ray Price. 7-6 Australia lead. 22 minutes of play in the second half gone. No tries. Fairburn's kick is unsuccessful. It's taken well by Rogers, who evades the first tackle. Evades the second, the third, and that's a good little bit of football by Rogers, let me tell you. Krillich now from dummy half. And there he goes. That's the first time he's run. That's a good run. And Krillich is showing that he's, well, not just a hooker. He can move in the over. Ready. Price coming on the burst nicely, but Reddy gets a bit of a late serve there, and down he goes. Well, it's as messy as you can see when they're trying to get to their feet. Fulton, Gerrard, Cranham doing... Oh, that could be a bad one! Bevan kicks, it's a chase now! Edie's after it too! They're going to get to him, Edie's there! Who is it? The referee says a try! I can't tell, everybody stood up in front of me. Bad error from Cronin, and if Bevan got to it, as the referee, who was 40 yards behind the play, I don't blame him, they're pretty quick out in the wing. If, as he agrees, it was a try, Cronin's going to have the error sheet at home for him. Now watch it. He tried to quick hand it along without actually catching it. Bevan was able to get his left foot to it. Now the race develops. Edie, the shoulder, and I'll give it as a try. I'll give it as a try, no doubt about it in my view. Bevan got a hand to it, and all you require is downward pressure. So while I doubted the referee's ability to see it from where he was, in retrospect and looking at it in second sight, that's a try. No, no, not that way, George. Just wide of a good length. The score remains 9-7. One try to Great Britain and three goals, making up their 9 points. Rogers feels that one well. Just inside the quarter now. Australia have got to maintain possession, and they've got to back each other up with the ball. Fulton, Edie coming in, injecting himself into the line. By about 18 metres out now from Great Britain's line. Gerrard again from dummy half. He's made some good inroads in that position today. Krillich, Fulton, ready. Lovely to Cranham, out to boost, that could go close. He does, and he makes the odd yard, and that's a great bit of play. And a great bit of play, and the Australians jubilantly jump to their feet as little Boosted goes in and scores a try. And that was a good clean try. No doubt in the wide world about that one, as the grum looking Great Britain bench there sits and stares. Let's see it again. Here was the play. The pass coming out to Reddy. Reddy onto Cronin, and he did so well that time. And doesn't that great that Cronin's been able to redeem himself from that previous error? A little boost that did so well to take the ball round that extra 2 metres and make the kick even fractionally easier for Mick Cronin. The experience now showing in Boosted to gain that extra couple of metres inward. He may just make the difference with a kick. The score, 10-9. Australia's way, the kick from Cronin is not successful. Cronin's kicking record today.
He's kicked 3 goals in 6 attempts now, Rex.
Owing bleeding from the cheek. Got some sort of a cut on the cheekbone. 10-9. And the other replacement on. Reddy gets the award of the man of the match. As Gerrard takes the kickoff. Now both the replacements are on for...
Yeah, Phil Hogan is the player on for Great Britain.
Now who's he replaced?
Well, normally he plays lock, so, but Steve Dorton's still there. Well, there's Thompson going to be spoken to.
Nichols will be the man, I think. No, Thompson, you're right. Attempted stiff arm, is it, or used a foot?
Used the foot.
Thompson being penalised. I'm still in a state of shock about the two halfbacks being sent off for throwing a few punches at each other, and then you get players cautioned for kicking.
I think the English player to just go off, Rex, was Len Casey, the second rower. There's Steve Neen warming up on the sideline for Australia as well. All right.
We've had 31 minutes of play. The penalty with Kulich. Olling, who again goes to ground with the ball, and this may be another field goal attempt coming up. As Craig Young came on and gave Nichols a nice little shoulder, knocked him out of the way, ready, straight and hard, only about 4 metres away, and the Australian side starting to show real signs of a revival now. Fulton, out to Olling. Got a pass back inside, miraculously to Edie. Edie back to Fulton, and Fulton going close. And there's Ward.
Ward and Edie.
And is it a try? Fulton's been allowed a try. Fulton's been allowed a try. The Australian managers, Peter Moore and his co-manager there, are going quite, the Jim Cole are going quite ecstatic about the whole business. We'll see that again. The referee took his time to allocate the try, but it's one to Bobby Fulton. Now watch as Olling does well here to get the pass back inside to Edie. Edie goes so close and then unloads one-handed to Fulton. Now Fulton's strength got him to that position. He still strains and fights. And he gets the ball now, no question about it. And the referee, only 3 metres to the side, agreed with that. Fulton, I think, has closed the gate on an Australian win in this game. The kick from Cronin is not a difficult one. It's only about 15 metres off centre, maybe 18 metres off centre. The score, 13 points Australia, 9 points to Great Britain. And I mention again that Rod Reddy has been given the Man of the Match award. Cronin, he's made no doubt about that one. Here's Boosthead, one of the try scorers, about 5 metres outside the Australian quarter. Craig Young. And that's better. Craig Young unloading well to Krillich on that occasion. Even those little short, quick passes will unsettle the defence. Ready. Nicely to Gerard, and that's offside. The referee has given it as a forward pass. They don't have offside passes in this, in England. It did look marginally forward. The referee better positioned than I to see it. And there's a penalty. Now, I don't think Great Britain are going to take a kick at goal, unless I miss my guess. We're into the 34th minute of play. They've taken the tap. Nichols, Holmes, the new replacement players. Hogan now receiving, I believe, his first touch of the ball. Millwood. A long floating pass, rather desperation one. That they're open to be intercepted. I think Millwood has diminished in pace considerably in the last season and a half since I've seen him play. Barry Ross?
Yes, that's right, Rex. Well, we were talking to Alec Murphy, weren't we, before the game, and he said that too.
A lot of the snap went out of this Great Britain side when Nash went off. There's Eric Hughes, who's received marginal opportunities out in the centre.
Those two Australian tries, Rex, they came after what you said, a bit of variation. Two runs up the middle by Gerard and then ready for the second try, and then the try came the next ruck.
Now then, good pass out there to Anderson, who scored or put down the ball over the line but had it called back after about a 50 metre run, and that would have been plenty of talk about that one, I would imagine, had it meant the result of the game. Olling, who was involved in the last Fulton try very well, and he's a bit slower to his feet on this occasion. Ready, Craig Young, who's had a very useful game. I think the steam has gone out of the Great Britain side. One senses that they're going through the motions at this stage. Ready? Nicely passed to Price. He's got himself into some sort of space up towards halfway. Australia running from left to right. Have got it pretty near in the bag, 15 to 9. There's Gerard again, proving that he's a fine international. And we may well have a little bit of drama coming up here.
Well, there's two Australians down there. Rod Reddy is one. I think the other is, I've got Graham Eady. I thought it was Graham Eady.
Is Rod Reddy?
Rod Reddy's to his feet now. Yes, he's sank down again.
Reddy's very sick and wobbly-legged at the back.
think the other's Ray Price,
number 13, you're right. And Steve Norton being spoken to by the referee.
There goes Steve Neen onto the field now for Australia.
And here's the action on what took place on that occasion. It was a shoulder charge on Reddy. Now Steve Neen is coming on.
Yes, he's talking to the linesman. He's got to get permission before he can go on.
The Australian side wearing, of course, their KB insignias.
And Frank Stanton's holding up number 12 the way they do over here to pull off Rod Reddy.
Well, Neen would be a very useful player for Australia at this point. He's got a high work rate, and with about 4 minutes to go, they just need tacklers out there. Fulton showing the ball in a runaround move, but not giving it and going on his own. Jeff Gerrard has proved a handful today. Fulton looking for a drop at goal. He's got a one between the goal posts, but didn't get any elevation at all. Thompson, well tackled. Again, Reddy and Thompson getting a slight altercation there. It's no use Thompson walking after Reddy. Reddy's only interested in the fact that his side's leading at the moment by 6 points. Long floating pass. It's anybody's. Who wants it? I'll take it, says Ray Price. Gets a pass away to Rogers. They won't want to give him any room. He'll go tearing through there. Touch judge in. And there's a player being decked. Reddy's down. Who's that player that's been called out?
I can't see it.
Eric Hughes.
Yes, well, Sydney viewers would remember that incident at the Sydney Cricket Ground when Rod Reddy was sent off for an incident with Hughes when he was with Canterbury. Perhaps it's a get square.
Well, there it is from behind, and I've seen players set off for less. And I repeat again my criticism of the referee's hasty action and sending them two of them off. It was punching only, and I think that sort of thing, a referee has to be a little bit broader in his point of view than to send players off in a test match. Cronin. Yes, unsuccessful.
Particularly after that last incident we just saw, which he allowed the English player to stay on the field.
Yes, it's been a very ordinary performance by the referee today, I'm afraid. There's the hooter, and in the background, the jubilation of the Australian players. And all the training bench have come on the field now to embrace the men. Millwood and Fulton shake hands there. The result, a good win. And let nobody have any doubts about it. 15 points to 9 to Australia. The first test, the Kangaroos tour of Great Britain.
Fulton, very, very keen to win this match, particularly because then, as he said, well, for the rest of the tour, they can relax to the point of wanting to make it, of course, a complete dry scrub. Well, I doubt if that would happen, but you never know. It's Great Britain on the left, Mick Norton in charge, and the first 10 minutes will be a stretching out and no doubt deciding if and where the strength and the skills are likely to develop. Graham Eady taking the fair ball and the players running up. Well, I would have thought it might have been offside. The referee said no, it was in the distance, but nevertheless, it's an advantage to Australia getting the ball quickly. Gerrard, Krillich, Craig Young, big crowd from of Australian followers come over with various tour operators. A nice one to Eady, and Eady is a strong man. And Eady still going. He's the man that Great Britain have got to fear. Graham Eady strong. The position is right from that first kick, and it could be on the sixth tackle. Ray Price very close. Now this offside and a penalty to Australia. George Nichols offside. John Atkinson in the back. A very good start with front.
This was very, very good tactics on Australian's part. Put the ball way up the field and then stood men offside, and George Furman fumbled the ball, and this is the start Great Britain didn't want it.
1 minute gone in this second test. This is the 28th test series. In the first test at this Here is Great Britain 9, Australia 15, 6-6 at half-time. Mick Cronin kicking, 26 goals, 2 tries. Looks down, pensive and particular, and it very close to a 2 points, which is what they want, and it's a goal. 2-0, that was of course a good start indeed by the Australians, with tactics of course pushing the ball into the Great Britain half. Tactics, do you reckon the sort of tactics they'll use?
Well, I think these are good tactics, and I think Mick Cronin will be very happy to see that ball go over, because the Australians have been a bit worried about Mick, and he's normally a very good goal kicker. I think he'll be pleased to see that one go.
Anderson, Chris Anderson, of course, experience of English league football. And this is the tactics they're going to play in the British half. That's going to be their tactics. Whether all the time remains to be seen. John Atkinson touching the ball for the first time. Steve Norton. Jim Mills. The first time Jim Mills has touched the ball. 25 yards line. 2-0 for the Australians. Big George Nichols. Typical George Nichols. And somebody out. Ryan Lockwood, number 10. Injured. I didn't see what happened then. I followed the play. Did you see anything, Alex?
Yes, there's a little bit of incidence off the ball here. And I think Bobby Fulton will be very lucky to stay on this field.
What? Let's have a look at that. Look at the man in possession on the 25-yard line, George Nichols. And there he went down, but being attended to. But these are the sort of tactics, obviously, the Australians in the first quarter of an hour are going to go hard.
Australia look as though they're going to play in our half, and they think they can hold us there, and we can't score from any length of the field. If we keep playing football, I think Great Britain are going to be in this game at the end.
See the taxi, but the kicker now taking it, being George Fairbairn. Looks up, should equalise the score. And the flags are up. 2-2. Bobby Fulton, very, very keen to win this match, and so have a fairly good time for the rest of the tour. The third test will be at Headingley, and if it is a decider, then it will be a full house, and nearly a full house here, not quite, but certainly a big crowd. Tony Fisher. George Nichols, and the referee having a word with kneeling on. And he got that out, he says, straight away. A lot of atmosphere about this match. George Fairbairn. Well, this is the incident that happened. The tackle came, and down he goes. And there was somebody coming on top of it. Craig Young. Been prepared to put the ball about. They're watching to get the ball out and give Jim Mills some work, but the Australians just line up on Mills. They know his strength. I was going to say we haven't seen much in the half-back, but little Stephen Nashie got a good pass then. A lot of Australian followers here, out of about 3,000, which says a lot for enthusiasm. Quite a lot of ex-players who brought parties in the white. Great Britain, 2-2. Goal each. Half time in the last test, it was 3 goals each, 6-6. Will there be anything great with a very good berth by Stevie Norton on the sixth tackle? 8 minutes gone on a penalty. And this George Fairbairn will be coming up. And of course, just to remind you that there are international rules. And George Fairbairn to kick, you'll see it as soon as it happens. 2-2 at the moment. And yes, it could be more so in the middle. 4-2. Trying to take the second kick and use, no doubt, a set-piece move, which they've got a lot of moves rehearsed. They have various names for them. And they're going to go, this looks a sort of back towards them, and then who's going to get it? Edie. They use Edie on that specialised move. Didn't come up, but the position is still there for them. And not very far, shall get Gerrard. Big, strong Rob Reddy. And Britain in trouble, position-wise. And a penalty. A penalty. A big crowd at the Oslo end, and a good, well, an easy goal, but a good goal. They've got a big kick, 4-4. Well, the Australian crowd, they've come from all over Australia, New South Wales and Queensland, and a very happy loss indeed at the moment, with one in the bag. With 20 minutes gone, Great Britain 4, Australia 4. Pushing the ball up. You see the tactics are so apparent. There's three or four people waiting for the reception committee, and he can't run very far, whoever it is. And there's the man, Edie, who can do it, Graham Edie. John Atkinson. Yards line. George Nicholas. The last 10 minutes or so have been with Australia, so far as position and aggressiveness is concerned. Brian Lockwood. A lot of experience, but of course Mills, Fisher, Lockwood and Nicol have been in Wembley for quite a while. And the referee calling everybody out. Craig Young on Tony Fisher, but Tony Fisher is up. And he's explaining what he must do with the elbow. There he's coming on to Fisher. Well, the position here, this better for Great Britain. A 25-yard line. Attacking possession. Fisher's willing to have a go, but he's very dirty. Forward, up front, cutting out the big fella. George Nicholls. Lockwood, Brian Lockwood to Steve Norton. Les Dill. Stand off half to loose forward to prop forward. Gunner to put him up from Millward. I don't know whether it was accidental. The test judge is in. So the test has come in for the incident. Lockwood and Reddy, Halleck.
This is a very bad late incident, said he. They're very lucky to stay on the field. He caught Brian Lockwood off the ball, and he looks as though he's hurt him pretty badly. He certainly deserves more than taking off.
Injured player being attended to. Well, from behind the post, that's a pretty good indication of what he's got to do. Just out on one side, hook it in. Both on this point of time. As usual, breathing in. And the flag is up. Donny Fisher. 2 minutes plus injury time. A very vital score here now to either team. To go in front to say a trying to go angle would indeed be very important. The referee having a penalising the Australian. A penalty. Score here is going to be vital if anybody gets one, Alex.
This is a very, very important part of the game, and George Fairbairn will make sure with his kick the next score could really clinch the game, even though it's so early in the game.
Well, what it does stand out is the fact that neither pack have got supreme methods of putting the other team forward out, because what have they been able to do is do this sort of thing, go forward. But the strength of the defence has been very, very evident. Vicky Mills, who I haven't seen a lot of him actually, they've come up very quickly onto him. Norton, using George, well, pulling out George Nichols and using Phil Lowe. Speciality tactics. A try here would be very useful, of course, to both teams. We've under a minute plus injury time. Oh, a nice one. Got Roger Millwall. He's going to be, I think, if he takes it over and gets the ball down, he gets a try. Gets a try, important try. Stuart White running through, and a great delight to make the score 9 points to four. Alex, can we have the right moment?
Well, that's the little man. He's just appeared at the right time. What a vital score. What a beautiful kick this was. Plays to perfection, right on the line. Stuart Wright didn't enough to bend down and to put his hands on it.
Fairbairn. Yes, yes, it's a clapper. A clapper, but it's 11 points to four, and a little smile from Roger the Dodger Millwall. He doesn't often really get into a big grin. Five-yard line, and the move could be useful. Holmes is an experienced player, and Roger, having had one or two knocks in a recent week, will at least give a lot of impetus and a lot of encouragement. John Holmes touching the ball for the first time, experienced player, is having his benefit here and doing a show for it, and I'm sure he'll be very glad to have something to show from this match for him. Chris Anderson on the left wing. John Joyner, who came about it to come in. Jeff Gerrard trying to beat the ball, and the dummy half not ready, Max Grillage. The Australians will start to put on pressure for the old Chemicals Trophy. Coming up quickly. And John Atkinson was very good there when he came up. John Atkinson read it as the sixth tackle. Well, there's enough experienced forwards up front, Mills, Fisher, Lockwood. In fact, altogether experience, Nichols and Lowe in the second row, and Norton moves forward. And Norton knows, of course, the Australian type of play that he's played in New South Wales. New South Wales and Queensland, the two parts of Australia where they're very strong in rugby league. The Australians, which of course is a lot of difference, 20 hours, they're watching this match in the early hours of the morning, although being Monday morning they'll have to go to work. Not as many as if it's on a Saturday. Jim Mills. Can't get it away, but just signs of strength coming back into the forwards. Holmes, not a bad one, it'll run, it's a good one. One thing about it, not a lot of obvious chatter going on. No doubt there is a lot, but not to the referee's hearing. Mr. Norton, a very pained official from witness. And a penalty. Enough tackling, now getting down. Commodore Donicus, not retiring. George Fairbairn. Kick in. George Fairbairn, 32 goals, 4 tries. Successes in 4 kicks he's had. Chance for a 5th one. Been on form, he has his own particular style. He breathes in, doesn't take a long kick, a little push up from the back foot. And the crowd say yes. The crowd answered that. It was a beautiful goal.
Well, that was a brilliant goal by George Fairbairn, and it was very, very welcome from the Great Britain point of view, because this is the time to score just on half-time as you're going off and just as you come back on after half-time. Never in doubt once you left your boots.
On the halfway line, Bobby Fulton and Radonikas are talking to the referee and asking what it was all about and why Radonikas was penalised for that kick, because that kick is a very, very vital one. They all are, I know, but that one particularly. And all that came, of course, from the John Holmes finding touch, clever touch finding, position kept, maintained, and then the goal coming. Jim Mills, big, strong, controversial. George Nichols, big and strong. And a knock on. Although he was facing the other way around, of course, he could have knocked it on Stevie Nash. Stevie not at all pleased with that. Scrum, 4-2. To Great Britain. Oh, well taken, quickly. John Holmes making his presence felt. George Nichols. So the temperature rising in this great big pool at Oxford Stadium, a ground that once had 104,000 unofficial and 120,000, I reckon. I was here in a Wembley replay, a big crowd here today. 13 points to 4. Fisher putting in a little traffic kick. Not a bad one, but of course the lively Graham Edie has been all into touch, and the penalised because he wouldn't let him get up to play the ball, and Mr. Norton said, Stuart Wright, you are wrong. Well, no doubt they pull him into touch. And Les Boyd comes on for Jeff Gerrard. So all the subs are being used now on both sides. So no doubt Jeff Gerrard, who knows English football well, I don't know the reason, haven't seen him yet, but maybe tactics. And what the referee now is getting very quickly onto the job with Graham Edie taking Paul Rose. Steve Rogers. Just a little out of sync now with the Australians, but they're quite capable, particularly Edie, who will be brought up, I'm quite sure. Steve Rogers, 13 points to 4. The Australians have got to score twice. Kangaroos, set piece, which they've learned. The referee very quickly onto the job and say, be careful. Well, I don't think he'll say be careful, but say something equivalent. Les Boyd. Ah, good play With 15 minutes to go plus injury time, shows what the Australians are capable of doing. They've still got Fulton, hasn't been quite as prominent, and moved in well out into the middle of the field, almost a left centre with been in possession. We haven't seen Dill have a long run for a while. Referee saying it was just pushed. Right, very good pass from Phil Lowe. Adrian pushes them up, passing but in touch. Well, John Holmes, who came on at half time for Roger Millward, and very experienced footballer. The referee is keeping well on the job. He's keeping everything tight. And it hit him, it was so tight. I thought he was coming in, Donny Finch was going to throw the ball at him. But he would have a nice word for him, I'm sure. John Holmes. Rose. 25-yard line. Second test. Don't think that Bill Lowe, who played just well in Australia life, didn't get up, he played ball.
Well, this is a very, very good ball from John Holmes. John Johnny does a tremendous job here. He comes inside two men, and what a lovely ball. He keeps his head and puts a ball out to Stuart Wright, who does very, very well to get in there and walk in the corner and leaves it to the sticks.
Eddie Rand. And the flag are up, and 18 points to 4. We're getting to the stage that would be a bit of a miracle now, but anything can happen in death match.
Well, this is what the rugby league football is all about. Great Britain have got the bit between the teeth, and Australia have certainly got a big task.
Tony Fisher. Sense of professionalism now about the Great Britain side in more or less all they're doing. Here's he's got to go down, says Les Boyle on Phil Lowe. Paul Rose has done a lot of hard drafting since he came on. And the Holmes kick will take out like a goalkeeper, Chris Anderson. Won't go a long way. You can sense a little bit of trouble in the Australian defensive work now with the early tries. There's just two tries, but unlike them, a lot of matches when teams fail to score against them. One, two, three, four, five, half a dozen. And only had their line crossed eight times. The green and gold of Australia, Bobby Fulton. Craig Young. Good way of getting the ball moving, but a lot of good tackling, particularly by Stevie Nash. There's a lot of work. And up and under. There's 4-1. It's a try. Think so. It's a try to Ray Price. Yes, it's a try. Ray Price, and he went up. It was an awkward one. 18 points to 7, Bobby Fulton. Well, this is the one that it came up and it was pushed back. Let's carefully look. There were 3 or 4 to 1. The ball went loose and Price got it. Steve Rogers to kick. Flags up. 18 minutes to 9 and 8 minutes to go.
I think George was a little bit unlucky there. He drew the ball clearly and somehow he got off balance. But Mick Nolan was quite right. It was a perfectly good try. And,
Referee gets up very quickly if he thinks there's trouble. And he knows the man who liked it cause trouble. Well, not cause it, but in at it. Remedy, not a quite as many individual runs as he had in the first half. Mousehead, and Ryan Lockwood, who's been voted the man of the match, deserved it. He's taken over as captain since Mould went, and he's done a very good job. He's not just five, but he's Australian now attacking. Max Grillage, and they're putting on a last minute, or not last minute, only about 7 minutes, but John Atkinson across to save that. And it's England now in the last spell. 18 points to 9. Penalty against Great Britain. The kick through. Just watch this. And obstruction, no doubt about it. Taking a little time to do it, which they needed time for the Australian. It's go 18 points to 11, Alec.
Well, is this a sign of a comeback from Australia? They certainly seem to be moving the ball a lot better and running with the ball, backing up a lot better now, but I think if knowing this Great Britain side, certainly they won't let a lead like this slip, and just playing football and tackling, that will just about do.
Just a little quietness in the crowd now. They've been very much on top in the situation they were in at the point of well in front at 18-4, but now 18-11. The sub, Les Boyd, needs an awful lot now of concentration by England, Britain. Redoning, full back lead, the man who could do so much damage. The Australians really putting on pressure. Great Britain getting the ball, Jim Mills, and that's as good as anything in getting possession. Number 14, Thompson, is out at the moment, but they're dealt with. I don't think the crowd is on the tip, but I don't think so. George Nichols wasn't particularly worried. And the Australians going in. 4 minutes plus injury time. 18 points to 11. Short one turned inside. Craig Young. For the Australian department one. Thompson has been making the attack and a good rubber.
Australians seem to be coming back into the game. Great Britain seems to be tiring a little bit, and I think time will just be about on their side. Rightly so, they deserve to win this game.
Well, Alf Richard is having quite a job with Thompson, and Frankie Stanton is looking at the player who is out at this moment, and is just coming round. Jim Mills and Australian possession. Australian running very fast. Great Britain not obviously able to get it across. It's fast with Radonikos in the middle. 25-yard line, Great Britain 18, Australia 11. Looking for support. Quite a bit of extra time, possibly. Moving the ball across to the wing. Going into the corner. Is it going in? Yes, it's going in. Steve Rogers. 18 points to 14. Moving the ball right across the field from the middle, went right across to the wing, and then it had to be scored. Rob Reddy had it, but he went out to the winger. And in he goes. Joyner was there to cover. Now he's not going to carry. There's a margin of 4 points, a try and a goal, and I believe that about 4 minutes, which including injury time, that is likely to be the figure. Great Britain 18, Australia 14, two tries each. And naturally, Great Britain not hurrying.
Well, this is a tactic. I don't think McNaughton will allow him to get away with this, but you can't blame him for trying. And I think the tactics will be now to put the ball deep in Australian half and tackle.
Britain have got a job on their hands to keep out, 18 points to 14. Final goal is 5 points. Certainly a lot of pressure now, which must come. The Australian crowd looking happy. They're rather pensive. A long one. Steve Rogers got the try. The tiredness possibly by some of the Great Britain players. But in injury time, got to hold out for another 2 or 3 minutes. A lot of power coming in and a very, very fit Australian side, Ed Boyd. Bobby Fulton up and under, but I don't know, a little under what they can see it at. And a beautiful tackle, but good play by both men there. Again, who's he going to talk to? I don't know. What he's going to do is looking towards an Australian, I think possibly to lose forward at Ray Price. Ray Price, he's spoken to.
Well, I think that Ray thought he got away with it here. He just dropped a little short one in, and he thought McNaughton had missed it, but. You can't miss a man with a beard, and rightly so, he brings him out.
George Fairbairn up. All in one bunch. Great Britain now going to hold and keep what they've got. Score is 18 points to 14. And the referee, Kerry Ousted, being spoken to. That is John Atkinson. In possession. Donny Fisher, and it'll be the sixth tackle to get as much time out of it as they can. 10 minutes, and even the crowd around is saying, "Can't, oh, Jim." Well, they're just going forward as much as they can. Lockwood coming on the best. Cruncher, Paul Rosen, a tackle, a tremendous. Lockwood pushing it out. Joan Nichols, over 2 minutes of injury time. They score 18 points to 14, a margin of 5 points, 4 points with a try and a goal, could make it 18-14, and they've made a lot of move up towards the Oxford end. Alex?
Well, this is the place to be when you're playing injury time, and Great Britain's surely instructing the
team. Well, injury time has gone, and that is it. The very, very hard second test for Great Britain equal the series. They win by 18 points to 14.
There's the Great Britain side. Fairbairn, Wright, Joiner, Bevan, Atkinson. Bevan was a winger. Replaces Dill, who's out. Millwood, Nash, Mills, Fisher, Farrar. Farrar comes in place of Lockwood. A lot of Australians will be happy to hear that. Nichols, Lowe and Norton. Norton passed the fitness test by Holmes and Rose for the reserves. The pitch is in superb condition. We've had light, very intermittent little spats of rain falling since early this morning. Leeds has experienced windy, blustery conditions for the last three or four days. The ground should be in apple pie condition. There's the Australian side. Graham Leedy, Kerry Boustead, Steve Rogers, Mick Cronin and Chris Anderson are the three quarters. Fulton and Radonikis are the halves. The forwards are Craig Young, George Paponis, Rod Morris, Jeff Gerrard, Les Boyd and Ray Price. The referee again, Mr. McNaughton. Fulton drives it deep down the middle of the field. Ricochet, stopped with a foot. Fairbairn has it. Fulton round the legs. Radonikis also there, fighting for a patch to grab hold of. Nichols. Penalty straight away against Fulton, I believe, for using a headbutt, was it? That's what he indicated. Pointed his finger at his head, Mr. Norton. First penalty of the match in the opening 20 seconds. Now, this Australian side has steamed up to a great degree, but let's hope that they play football. They'll need to play more constructively than they did in the second test. That's the end shot, looking back down the ground from the northern end. Packed audience. Fisher, who always takes it up like that now. Great Britain side. Still low. Referee going back about 9 yards there. A little bit more than the five. That was one of the very big complaints the Australian side had in the second test, that Norton kept them back so far on the ruck. It's Farrar there, who played for South Sydney, not with any great success. There's the first knock-on of the game. And Australia a bit slow to react. Peter Moore, Frank Stanton and Jim Cornwall, the officials, a little bit grim-faced over there. Let's see how Paponis goes. Yeah, did I say Farrar with South Sydney? I meant Farrar with Cronulla. He didn't play with a great deal of success out there. But he's highly thought of in English football and came in as the automatic selection when Lockwood was out. First scrum winner was Australia. Cracks the defence, first up, almost to the halfway line. Rogers at dummy half. Radonikis, Craig Young, nicely unloaded to Fulton. Fulton goes through the gap, streaming along, caught by one leg and a good tackle too from Bevan. Fulton runs from that, gets a very heavy high tackle there, it should be a penalty. Craig Young wanting to come in and go on it. Fulton is down. He took a heavy high tackle. I don't think you could really kill Bob Fulton with a heavy sledgehammer. But there's no questioning that the knock came in hard and high from Tony Fisher. And Norton quick to indicate that he'll have no more of that. Here's the man. Talking to his captain, Roger Millward. Mick Cronin to take the kick from about 12 metres outside the quarter and about 20 metres in from sideline. Very quickly, Pearce, Oliphant, Neen, Reddy and Owing are all injured in the Australian tour. Can you give us a progress over the next minute or two on how they're going?
Well, Steve Neen is about 75% okay, according to Dr. Bill Monaghan. And we'll be playing when they reach France in about a week or two. Greg Pearce is going home tomorrow night in the plane. Graham Olling has got a bad back and he'll be fit to play in France, as will Rod Reddy, who has recovered well. And Greg Oliphant will be playing early next week in France, or will be available for selection.
Right, so that's the up-to-date casualty report on the injured Australians so far on this tour. With Cronin, the opportunity of the breeze at his back. First blood to Australia, and they lead by 2 points to nil. Dominguez. Yeah. Gerrard on the burst and nicely. The bonus goes to dummy home. It's Fulton. Out to Edie. Back inside to Boosted. Going nicely. Up over the quarter. Good bit of play there by the very youthful wing three quarter. Rodonica standing by. The runaround holds it, gives it back into Craig Young. Gets a pass back to Gerrard, who makes a further 4 metres. And this is much better football from the Australian forwards. Rodonica's Fulton. Cronin. Cuts out a man. There's Edie. Edie comes into the line, evades the tackle. Yes, he does. Still going. Inside the England quarter. Rodgers. Here's the bomb. Fulton. Up they go, all onside. Fairbairn's lost it. He should be offside, that England player. It's a penalty to Australia. Quite right. The referee had no option there. Millward came round in an offside position, fell on the ball in that position, and regardless of what he says, the England captain, he knows he was offside. Statistics, Barry Ross.
Penalties favour Australia at this stage, 3-2, and the scrums are 1-1.
Another 2 points. Australia lead by 4-0. There he goes for a long, low kick in the face of the first bounce. Well stopped there. He's just got outside the corner. 10 metres outside. Australian forwards leaking with each other a lot better, backing each other up better. That was a badly played ball, and he's called for the knock right, and there's a penalty for dissent. And they should learn. I mean, this is stupid. I thought Boyd was pulled off the ball there. In other words, I don't think he was given the opportunity to play it, but absolutely useless to open your mouth and complain. He's about 35 metres out. He's only a metre or two off centre. He's around the corner style. The breeze is coming directly into him. There's Price praying, watching the ball, or hopefully for him, going off the upright. He's hooked it badly, which is the sometimes trait of these round-the-corner kickers. So the score remains Australia 4, Great Britain 0. Boyd. Fighting his way through several tackles. There's the ball being lost. Well, I think in Sydney football we would certainly have seen a penalty awarded for reaching through the ruck there. This is absurd if they're going to squander possession. Now, referee is talking again to the Australians and saying, keep your mouths shut. And he's right. It's a Rodonica's feed. And it's a clean heel to England. And the ball passed right to Fulton. What a shocking bit of football. Well, England just as much at fault now as Australia in the business of erring when in possession first time. Craig Young. He's around about the quarter line. On the wide blind side. Watch the way they play the ball. Along the line it goes to Cronin. Cronin stood up, got it away nicely to Edie. Edie out to Rodgers. There comes Boosted back inside. He's evaded 1-2, going very well. Unloads nicely to Mopotis. Mopotis has got men outside. Gives it away to Rodgers. Rodgers is up the sideline, near touch. And there's been a forward pass, has there? Yes. Mr. Norton's called it forward. Back on the 10 metres, the Australian side of halfway. Now, there was the pass. Do you believe it? He cut out a man. I'm not going to pass an opinion on that. I was watching the actual play, but there's a loud roar against the decision. Millwood out to Nash. Great scoring opportunity for Australia from a beautiful boosted run. Norton. Back to Nash. The referee got Australia back a pretty fair distance on that ruck again. There's Farrar. He gets heavily sorted out. And loses the ball. And the referee has now penalised Australia for stealing the ball. That was against Price for going in after a tackle had been called. Gets it over the halfway line. That's about 10 metres into Australia's half. The score again, Australia 4. Great Britain 0. Struck 10 metres inside. Great Britain 10 metres in from the sideline. That's Australia's ball. The knock is to Fulton, a run around. Fulton goes to his own. Doesn't unload the ball. Boyd, strong. Tackle but not put out. Gets up and goes to within 5 metres of the Great Britain line. Morris, Price, Rodonicus hung up almost over the line, only a metre short. Papadis so often scores from this position. Can he do it today? He's going to try. He's in. It's a try. Papadis in for the try. So how many times has George Papadis scored a try from dummy half? Well, I think he's scored about 9 tries this year for Canterbury. Watch it again. He seems incredibly strong in these positions. Driving hard with the legs right through the feet of the England ruck. And under some of the big men to score. In a handy position. There it is. So the Australians score in license now. To 9-0. So that's the score on Australia 9. Great Britain yet to open their account, but looking like it on numerous occasions. And this is very much an open game at this stage. Statistically, Barry?
Well, penalties. England way in front at this stage, 9-3, and the scrums have jumped away to a 6-2 position lead.
Which opens the question, can Australia keep defending at this rate? They've got such an imbalance of possession that the team tends to tire badly if they have to keep this sort of pressure tackling up constantly. Cameras are capturing all the little asides, the little cameo pieces.
That penalty to Australia broke an 8 penalty sequence to England. They had the last 8 before that in succession.
Right, well, it's a Rogers kick that's made some good gain. I keep pointing to this breeze. It's a substantial breeze. It's a 20 knotter, and Australia have the benefit of it. England will have it in the second half. Halfway, a touch judge on. Now we've got an England player being cautioned. Fisher's being spoken to here, is he? And a penalty goes to Australia, which makes it now
10-5.
2-1. One try to the Australian side being scored by George Papanis. Taking it through from dummy half. 3 goals from 3 attempts by Mick Cronin. There's 2 penalties and a goal. And Fairburn, I believe, has had 2 three kicks and goal for no success. Now, waiting for a ball to come back. We've got the situation they use one ball only during a game over here. Now, the tap move, this is an east move. Fulton takes it, goes not very far as Lowe gets him around the legs. Rodonicus Oh, Boyd running magnificently. He's gapped them. It's a try and a half. He's cut them to shreds. That is a crazy try. I tell you, he was like a runaway locomotive. He's torn the heart out of the English pack, and they should all get out of their knees and pray to God that they won't be castigated. I said castigated for that. Watch this. Between two of them. Not a hand laid upon him. A slight attempt by Fairbairn to put him down and underneath the post in a most incredible solo try. There was never a try on, and he just laid him over. And really, that was an appalling defensive display by the England forwards. They're absolutely horrifying. So Australia's scooting away now, with the time coming round towards the halfway break. A couple of minutes perhaps to go. That makes Mick Cronin's 500 points for the season, 78.
Yes, 501 now, Alex. Incredible effort, isn't it?
It is indeed. Well, Les Boyd need do nothing for the rest of this game. Radonikis has carved him up. Gerrard's away. He'll go on and score. They're not going to catch him. Put it down as another runaway try and an absolute killer for Great Britain. Well, they've torn the heart out of this England side in the 2 minutes before half-time. Gerrard went away from Milford, but what's the lead-up to it? As Radonikis slips the tackle of Farrar, who should not be on the field. He's been totally ineffective. The beautiful time pass to Gerrard. Gerrard, look at him. He's a three, he's a forward, and he runs away from two England backs. He doesn't ground the ball that well, I must say. Unfortunately, the referee was well back. Anyway, that's the place to score them, and the score becoming a little bit of an embarrassment at the moment. Two tries and perhaps two goals in the space of 2 minutes. Incredible. I wonder if Frank Stanton's smiling at the moment. If it is, it'll be the first time on the tour at a game. Yes. Cronin raises the flags again. That's his fifth consecutive successful kick and goal. And Australia Subaru, say the supporters. And from the kickoff, the ball goes between the legs of the Australian player. The referee's claimed a knock on. I'm not going to argue with him about that one. Could well have been his hand. And there is a very disgruntled England coach getting up and just constantly walking towards the dressing room without a smile on his face. The England side went off. So at the half-time break, we've got a scoreline that reads Australia 19, Great Britain 0. The score is Barry.
Boyd and Gerrard, the second half, is a trial each, and Cronin and a try. Cronin is a try. Cronin has kicked 5 goals from 5 attempts.
Well, Australia coming back, and I have no doubt that Frank Stanton, their coach, has hammered into them the fact that complacency would be very remiss. Possession is still one of the critical things. Australia have only won 2 scrums and the Great Britain side have won 6. The scrum and the penalty ratio is 10 to 5 against them. So, with that sort of possession, Great Britain should have done a lot more. Obviously, it denotes a very fine defensive record by the Australian side. It's gone into the end goal area, over the dead ball line, a restart from the quarter line. Well, England taking full advantage of this fairly strong breeze which is blowing down along the ground. Craig Young, he's about 8 metres outside the Australian quarter. Ray Price runs from dummy half. The 10 metres gain. Opponents, Radonikis, Fulham, out to Gerrard standing wide. Scorer of a superb first half try on the blind side again to Opponents. They're up towards the halfway, still going. He's lost the ball. England have it. Oh, made a meal of that. Australia have got it back. Some terrible blunders being perpetrated by Great Britain at the moment. Fulton runs from dummy half. 5 tackles to go. They've got about 30 metres of ground to cover. Radonikis, Cronin, Rogers, long floating pass out to Boosden. And he's well tackled, but not into touch.
That's Bevan on the wing for England now, Rex, and Holmes in the centre.
Right, Holmes will be playing at number 14. Bevan on the wing at number 4. Australia now with Gerrard charging at the line again, wanting number 2. They lead by 19 points to nil. Moving the ball very fast. Grona standing deep, winding himself up. Turns it back inside to Rogers. Rogers has beaten one man, two, still going. Can't unload the ball just before he's tackled and goes to ground about 15 metres out. Fulton with a kick. It's off the goal post. It's anywhere.
A drop goal.
Yes, indeed. So Alf Richards smiling. That's young Ian Thompson, the forward replacement there. The Bobby Fulton standing on the open side of the ruck. A little chip drop. Ball hardly touched the ground. A ricochet, almost a cannon off the cushion, if you like. But it counts a point. That makes it 20 points to nil. Australia back standing very flat on this occasion. There's a penalty to Great Britain. They should take the kick for touch. That would have been an error had Nash gone for the tap. There's another 40 or 50 metres of ground to be going down there. Watch the breeze. The lights I've mentioned already have been on since the start of the second half. There's a very long kick from Fairburn. It made him again at about 35, 40 metres, and that of course is the way to play the game. Now, showing a marked lack of enthusiasm to get on with the game. Fisher. They will do his usual thing, which is totally, in my view, negative. And the crowd are even booing the England players now for lack of, well, shall we say, skills. Or enthusiasm. Nash, Farah, Nash, Nichols on the boil. 10 metres out, that was good stuff. Nash, Norton, Holmes, Fairburn, steps, goes, going nicely. 10 metres away, got the pass to Nash. Nash out to Fisher. Fisher away to Holmes, dancing but not going anywhere. Gets it to Bevan, he's caught by one leg. The pass comes back to Lowe, who's done a grubber kick, but it's gone too far. And that was the first sustained bit of attack by Great Britain since really early in the first half. The crowd loved it. The kick dead, it gives the opportunity to Australia to get the ball back on the court. There's the faces of some of the England men. Lockwood was there, and the referee, Billy Thompson, who's and Australia have lost possession. It's Lowe standing wide and making a lot of room for himself. And it's a great run by the big England second rower. He's torn a hole in this Australian defence. Millwood, Mills, Meadie wraps him up high.
So there's Boyd's shoulders gone. He's calling for assistance.
Yes, well, young Ian Thompson may well get a run at this stage. Farah. Nichols, the dummy, but doesn't unload the ball. Unloads it now to Nash. Nash going well. He's only 2 metres away, the Australian defence, under constant threat now in the early part of this second half. Here's Nichols, gets it away to Millwood. Millwood, a little grubber kick through. Hand Anderson's there first, and the ball went over the dead ball line anyway. Well, Alf Richards, the trainer, coming on. There's Craig Young. Have a look through the binoculars and see Liam Thompson stripping, Barry. Ray Price making a raid up the blind side of that ruck. Radonikis, who's had a fine game today. Out to Cronin, standing deep. Cronin puts his shoulder into the defence, gets it. Still stood up there. And sucks about four of them to him. Off him calls the referee. Radonikis. Fulton. Farah, swinging right arm. I don't think Farah could knock a sick girl off a chair, to be quite honest, but that's only my opinion. Craig Young.
We're seeing Thompson on the sideline now.
Number 12 to come off. Australia now into England's half, but it's a sixth tackle. Now there's the young giant, Ian Thompson from the Manly Club, number 15. He'll replace Les Boyd. There's Boyd, the scorer of a magic try in the 33rd minute of the first half, that he'll long remember. Thompson now goes into the front row. And it's an England ball. Norton standing up in the tackle there. And the England side being booed for not backing him up. Nash. Blind side of that ruck there. A little Nash again goes to dummy half and runs from there, but there's no support. Joiner at dummy half. Farrah. Philwow winding up. Nash swivels and gives it to Millwood on the blind side. Up to Bevan on the left. Norton. And the intercept taken by Cronin. Cronin shows the ball on the inside but elects to go on his own. Australia back in possession on the blind side. They come. Young Thompson now charging straight ahead. He should involve himself in much of the play now for a while. He's fresh. There's Gerard tearing another hole up the blind side of that English run. 20 points to nil, Australia lead. We've had about 8 minutes of the second half. Cronin, Rogers, the lights are on and the shadows are here fairly long at Leeds. Third and deciding test. Well, Pyonce is the referee. Edie's injected himself into the three-quarter line. Running crossfield. Unloads it well. Boustet's, Anderson's got it. The pass was a bad one, but he's got it. He's now been ripped off by Joiner in the middle of the field. Rodonigas, Craig Young. Back inside, the Great Britain defence under a great stretch at the moment. Rodonigas, a long pass to Cronin. Cronin straightens, goes, tries to get himself moving in a forward direction there rather than cross field. Fulton, Heaney, good tackle. Pulled down well by Rod Morris, unloaded to Boustet. Good footwork, the little fella. And that's the sixth, or he's put it a touch. Rose, the replacement forward, who's come on as Fisher went from the field. Mills, who's been very, very quiet all day. One good pass earlier to put a support in the clear, and that's all. Farrah. Low. Beautiful pass to Millwood. Millwood will bounce the ball. He's bounced the ball. He's awarded a try, my heavens. Love to see that in the action replay. I'll be bound that it deserved a try. I don't think there's any doubt about that, but in my view, he bounced the ball. Good football from England. Everything deserved the try. Lowell. Edie's tackle. Now watch closely. This is the one that's going to tell whether the referee erred or not. Does he bounce the ball at this point? It fell out of his hands. Fairburn, who's had no success at all. And continues with an upright rebound. So 20 points to 3, the scoreline, with 15 minutes of the second half gone. Cronin from the restart. Played soccer. Steve Norton, who's played some soccer during the early part of his career when he was a lad. Vera. Side of the ruck, England kicking. Boustet doing his level best to keep that one on the field, but that's good tactics by Millwood, using the bruise intelligently, driving the play downfield. And a scrum to go down on the Australian quarter line. This is going to be a real test of stamina for Australia because they've won so little possession and they've all lost that scrum. And there's a penalty against Australia for not being back to 5 yards. Millwood takes the tap quickly. The referee calling them back about 8 metres. Millwood, Leo on the boil. A test of stamina and a test also of character for this Australian side. On the blind side, De Mills. Mills is not going anywhere. But They should put him down. Nash, Farah, oh, what a horror. And well picked up by Nod, who unloads nicely to Wright, who evades the fallen Rod Morris. The play directly in front of their commentary position. Nash, Farah, Nichols, a long pass along the ground, but it's taken well. Holmes has it, the pass has gone out. He's taken it away to Bevan, and Bevan gets it down. And there's a score wide out for Great Britain after a good sustained play. And that was a good try. 20 points to 6. And Australia literally bleeding to death at the moment for a lack of possession. But watch it again.
Well, the Scotland are 11-2 England's way, and that's 5 this half of England, 5-0. The penalties 13-5 England's way, 3-0 this half.
Thompson charging straight ahead and gets to his feet quickly and plays it. That's what this game's all about. A runaround move with Rodonagus half through the gap. Price goes to dummy half. Legend to Fulton, back to Price, the runaround. He's been a non-stop player on this tour, Ray Price. Rodonagus standing nice and deep. Out to Thompson. Thompson running off the edge of the ruck, unloads it back inside to Gerrard. They're only about 15 metres away now. On the blind side they go. Rodonagus away to Thompson. Thompson unloads nicely to... And the referee has pulled it back. Needy it was.
Real forward pass, I think.
Yes, well, nobody will argue with him here. Our angle just doesn't help to... he was in for a touchdown. But there's a scrum win, unusually. Rodonagus, the dummy, he's going to go in himself as he is. He's cut him to shreds on the blind side. A poorly bit of defence by Norton and Nash. And there he is, a little bloke who'd rather score a try in a rugby match than have a feed, I feel. Great Britain 23, Australia 23, Great Britain 6. Right. Successful. Scoreline. Australia 23, Great Britain 6. Rodonagus being told to put it in again. Scrum right down about 10 metres, 12 metres out from the Australian line. It shoots out the back of the Australian scrum. Anderson has it. He evades one tackle. He evades Norton. He's up towards the corner. This is a good run by Anderson in a parabola. Alan Thompson. And to the ever-present Rod Morris. Fulton. Craig Young. Nicely back to Fulton. Fulton dummies to one player, can't get a pass inside. Almost time up. Australia leading by 23 points to 6. A few punches being thrown there. It's not going to worry any of the Kangaroos at the moment, I can promise you. There's a penalty gone to Australia. Saying in rugby league circles and sporting circles, the winners can laugh and the losers can do their own thing. Time by our stopwatch is up, but the referee, of course, will allow something from injury time. Inside the Great Britain quarter.
George Pappone is claiming a free kick then because the Englishmen were not back the 10. Probably remembering when Norton did that to the Australians not so long ago.
Yeah, Thompson, number 15, the replacement forward. Fulton's a dummy half. Out it comes along the line, out to Cronin, turns it back inside. Alan Thompson was the man at the bottom of that tackle. Rodonagus, Fulton, it's gone up in the air, Norton knocked it. Ricochet gets up and plays it. Great Britain side merely going through the motions now. They've got their reputation a little bit in shreds after today's inept performance. Millwood, that is going to go fairly soon now. We're well over 2 minutes of extra time. Farah. There's a bad bit of football, trying to swing the pass around, but six to go, says the referee. Farah. Let's see some of his ball moves. Well, he did get it away well, but it was a bit hard. Hit the player on the thigh, so again the play breaks down. Nash has been, I think, comprehensively outplayed by Tommy Rodonagus in today's match. And Tom needed a good game against him, and the little fellow's come with a run, but lost the ball. Edie, who's gone from fullback to left wing through a knock on the thigh, is there to stop their progress. Rodonagus. Ray Price. And there's the hooter. And Australia have won the match 23 points to 6. And they've retained the Ashes. The final statistics, Barry Ross.
Scrums favoured Great Britain 14 to 6. The penalties finished up 17-9, also Great Britain's way. Australia's 23 points, tries from George Papanis, Les Boyd, Jeff Gerrard and Tom Rodonagus. Mick Cranan, 5 goals from 6 attempts, involved 4 field goal.